Well, good morning. And right now, in this episode, we will be looking into President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi's inauguration of the Safaga Marine Port, as well as Army Marine new special units within the 2nd Fleet Brigade. And joining us right now is in the studio is Engineer Mr. Singh. Good morning, sir.
Well, first of all, talking about these mega projects taking place when it comes to the ports in particular, and talking about the importance of the port of Safag right now, especially that this is one of the oldest ports actually in Egypt. How do you see the importance of this project during this period of time in particular?
In this period of time, this marine port is very important to be developed because it is a gate for the passenger, especially for the Gulf country to and from, and also for the car tourism. This is very special for the people in the Gulf country to Hurghada and Safaga to enjoy the warm and whatever more than place can visit. And also, this port is used for trade to and from Africa and southeast of Asia. So it is very, very important to be developed. And I think it is the second step after the development of Hurghada Marine Port also too.
Yes, Engineer Samir Salama, actually the port itself is said to cost almost 510 million. And in addition to that, there'll be also other projects inaugurated. How do you see the role of the area itself of Safaga in the development of Egypt in general?
Safaga is a place for tourism. It is an important issue. And also many industrial and mining projects there. Mm-hmm. So this port is important for this area to facilitate the trade to and from this
area. As long as, sir, you mentioned trade, let's talk about it, about the impact of such a project on the economic status in general, so especially included many other countries as well.
Economic and trade is twice. You can't separate between the economic and the trade. You have a good trade, you have a good economic. So when I talk about trade, I already talk about economic, which we will able to be a pioneer for in the area. And already any port or any marine port is a plus to the economic of any country.
Yes. What about enhancing the trade with Saudi Arabia and the Gulf states? Yeah. Would it help in that, being overlooking the the Red Sea?
Yes, as I told you, or yes, as I speak, this port is very, very important to the trade between Egypt and the Gulf country, even import or export. Mm-hmm. And also, it is very, very, very important for people or for passenger to go from Egypt to Gulf country and vice versa.
Well, talking about these mega projects in general, and maybe some people, when they say that still they're not going to feel it so in the near future, and how far is this important? How can we show that these projects will be the pillars of our economy for our future? And I believe this project will be one of the near future actually objectives.
To know the impact of this development of this sport, you have to see this port before the development. It's very poor. Mm-hmm. And no facilitation for the people. Everything is very, very old. Now, I think we have a very, very special terminal for passenger. It uses what the world and to for IT communication and all facilitation for the people. So I think anyone have to go to Safaga port will be very, very, very facilitated to and feel comfort in using this terminal, which one important part of the project.
Yes. Now, what do you think should be the next step following today the president hopefully will be inaugurating the port and some of the mega projects? What do you think should be the next step?
The next step, I think, is the development of the area of Safaga itself. Mm-hmm. I think Safaga is now go to very, very wide steps as a tourism
destination?
Or yes, or tourism government. But I think it will be dealt with the industrial, with mm-hmm. the economic projects in this area to have or to use the facilitation of this port to connect with the other countries. Mm-hmm.
So talking about the challenges facing this project and talking also about who will be included in all of the the establishment of the project and the access as a whole.
I think the project is finished. So we have to talk about what's the next, as you asked me. What's the next? It will be outside the port, the area beside or around the port. We have to use a good using for the area or for the land around this port to be one of the figures which lead to good economic and good trade. And
so we're working about investment. That's what
yes,
I'm asking
yes,
about,
yes,
talking
yes,
about
yes.
the challenges
yes,
of the
yes,
project.
Yes.
Like, for example, when we were talking about the Suez Canal, for example, and we were talking about the whole area around, it's not only the project itself. I think it is the same for Safaga as well, because Safaga is a very
is
important part
very, very good
of
idea.
The Red Sea.
Why we haven't authorization for this area, like the authorization for the canal Suez area. So why not? The investment in this area is very, very challenged and very, very have many, many benefits for economic and for investors themselves. So why not? We have to step these steps and think about the organization or authorization for this area to be developed and to be one of the economic centers in Egypt.
Yes, and actually, especially that Safaga actually is quite close to Luxor. The road itself, many of the overday tours, like sometimes people coming from the ports, they take the road and they visit Luxor and
yes.
they visit Upper Egypt. So it can enhance also tourism and can help in the development of parts of Upper Egypt as well.
Sure, sure. Safaga is important port, marine port, for the passenger mm-hmm. and, as I said, for the car
yes.
Tourism. So they make some tours in Safaga and then go to directly to Luxor and to Aswan by cars or by buses to enjoy this.
So do you feel that
places.
Then we need to also work on our road networks so that
and
offer
it.
More facilities on
yes,
the road
yes, yes,
so
yes,
that
yes.
we can then create like a type of a resort area that would be connecting between Safaga and Luxor
already
and other tourist destinations?
There is a road connecting Safaga.
There is, but
yeah.
I mean working
but
on it. Yeah?
Already now.
They are working on it?
Yes, yes, working on developing it. And many lateral road between the Upper Egypt and the coast of Red Sea. Many, many roads planned to be finished and to be established to help this area to connect to the Red Sea and have windows to beaches and to tourism.
What kind of investments we are talking about? For example, they are talking over there about a project already taking place, talking about the solar energy to provide electricity. What else, what kind of investments we can talk about?
The energy is a good point because this area is famous by the winds as a natural source. So many areas, when you go through from Sokhna until Hergad and Safaga, I think you face many, many, many stations of wind energy and also for sun, using sun to have energy for this area. And I think it is good idea to use these natural sources to have the energy in these places.
So, as Najwa was mentioning, the energy sector, what other type of investments or other type of infrastructure projects can take place and occur there?
I think infrastructure, the government already take place in their mind or in mm-hmm. their planning, mm-hmm. and the investor have to go to this area to mm-hmm. Make something to Egypt. I think if they take this step, it will be good news for Egypt and the economic of Egypt.
How to prepare our youth for such projects? Talking about human resources, this is one of the most important challenges we are talking about in all aspects, in all respects. So talking about the preparation of our youth, how can we work on this? Because definitely whoever who is going to work in this projects, in all these projects, our youth. So how can we prepare them?
The people in the Upper Egypt need more chances for have a work or have a jobs. So the human resources already exist.
They exist, but I'm talking about efficiency. I know they are existing everywhere, but I'm talking training, about preparations, everything. Training,
yes,
all of
yes,
these things.
Yes, how everything by training will be good. Will be able to do what we need from them. So there will be a program for training for these people to have a good job and to help the economic even their families and their country, Egypt.
So maybe the idea of having some institutions to take place over there for preparation of the youth, for training centers or something
I
like.
I think because we deal with many projects, any project comes to be alive or to be on the land, subjected to a training for the people to how to deal with this project. Mm-hmm. Even machine, even planning, even communication. So the training is a part of any investment in a project. So the human resources, I think, it is so easy to have a good people to a good project by training, by using the experience in the other countries.
Well, I'm going to borrow one of your questions, Najwa, because she likes small and medium enterprises.
Yes.
So I'm going to borrow your question and I'm going to ask you, is there room for youth to start small and medium enterprises as part of the development projects in Safaga?
I don't know, sure, I don't know, because it is a wide area and the investors who have to think about what they can do. Mm-hmm. At Hawaii or the what is the project? They can pay their monies. Mm-hmm. They have to search. They have mm-hmm. to study. Mm-hmm. Everything is by studying. Yes. The visibility study
but
for
but away from this, maybe talking about the small and medium enterprises, because these again are the pillars of building an economy. Mm-hmm. So talking about in general, of course, you know the nature of the area. And whenever we talk about a mega project, we cannot separate it from the small and medium enterprises because they are the basics for this project.
Yes, yes, yes. Till now. Safaga, I think it's famous by tourism. Till now. Mm-hmm. So what if they have any idea for small and medium projects, it will be good. There is a people who think about this idea and can help the youth to be able to go through these projects and have the benefits for them and, I said, for the Egypt as a small economic or as a small economic for projects or small project or medium project. And so I can't tell you what, because it's out of my experience, but I think there in Egypt many, many people who can think about what the small or medium projects which can help the people and help the area.
Well, also, President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi is expected to open the new construction project in Safaga and will be launching the Golden Triangle Mining Development Project. How do you see that?
It's very good because, as I said, the triangle, the Golden Triangle, is containing Safaga and many governorates from the upper Egypt, which can develop these governorates and make chances for work and for small projects for the people or for the youth especially to overcome the poverty, overcome of the unworking people, overcome the leak of chances to be to have a jobs for this area, especially in the upper Egypt.
Yes. Well, actually, I'd like to go back to a topic which we discussed with you before, but there were certain points which we haven't covered, which is the navigation between Lake Victoria and the Mediterranean Sea, which is expected to double economic growth due to the increase in the trade between member states and the outside world. So would you elaborate on that topic and tell us what's the latest news about it?
The latest news that Egypt, as a rule of the feasibility study of this project, planned and already have a wide step to arrange a training courses about the navigation and river transport for the footprint countries or the countries concerned in this project. The training will be in the river transport authorization and in some places in irrigation ministry, they cooperate to have a good courses for the engineers from this country. We already have two engineers from each country, equal about 18 person. They have well-prepared courses about the navigation, about the river transport, about the vessels, about everything concerned to the river transportation.
Yes.
These courses, we asked the country to have or to send the people who will cooperate with the PMU or the project management unit in the future to finalize or to go through this project, so even study or implementation of.
So what about its impact on the economy, and when are we going to, because I know still it's not into action, right? So when will we start about it, and what about its impact on the economy?
The economy for Egypt is will have high influence, because when you know that every trade movement from the locked country as Uganda, Ethiopia, Burundi, Rwanda, south of Sudan will go through Egypt to go to Europe. This will be a good for the economy of Egypt. And also, when we use this navigation route to have some transport from this country, it will be a little bit good in cost, because the cost of using the other modes of transportation, I think it's more expensive than the river transport.
Now, how feasible is it? Because right now it's going to pass through many countries.
Yeah.
And the route and the terrain itself of the countries, especially we know, like for instance in Egypt, if we look at the terrain of the River Nile, for instance, we have the granite, we have diorite, we have some hard rocks in the passage, passing through some of these African countries, the terrain itself would be hard. So has there been studies, how would it go, which pass it would take, and the cost and the estimate of such a mega project?
The cost will depend on what we will do to overcome the obstacles in this route. We have already obstacles, many obstacles, but we have a pre-feasibility study introduced to COMESA to convince the people that this project is very, very, very good and will be able to make benefits for every country in the system. But already we know, or we explained that we have many obstacles in this project, but when we look around in the world, we have many, many examples that for similar project have similar obstacle and they overcome. So why we also overcome this obstacle?
What are these obstacles and what are these challenges?
Most of them is the variation in the level, especially beside in the front or in the rear of the dams or power station. So we can use some diversion canal or as we said the technology of vertical elevator which take the vessel in their lock and move it from
like
the upper
lock?
Level to the down level and go through again to the road.
So do we know so far talking about the funding or
yes.
So how much is it allocated for the project?
Already Egypt finalized the pre-feasibility study as a fund from Egypt Governorate. Now we're working in the feasibility study, phase one. We have a fund from the African Development Bank, about $650,000.
Thousand or million?
Million, I'm sorry, million dollar. Yeah. $6,000 million. To funding the phase one of the feasibility study, which deal with the legal and.
And the total cost is?
The total cost, we talk about 10 million.
Okay, so if they are providing six, so Egypt will be taking the rest, right?
No. We look about, look for. The cooperation with many many donors like the African Development Bank, the World Bank, the Islamic Bank, and so on. We cooperate with the yes.
Yes, I'd like to ask a question about that. Excuse me for interruption. Now, this canal will pass through several countries. So, would each country cover the cost of carving the canal or digging the canal within its own land, or Egypt will be taking the loan on its own? How would it work? Like each portion, each country will be responsible for the part it's passing through, or would it be the responsibility of the loan itself carried on the shoulder or burdened by one country?
Yeah. It is a cross-border project, so many countries already have their rules in the project. So we have a steering committee from all the countries concerning this project. We talk about now about the obstacles and to the solutions. When we know the obstacles and their solution, we can calculate the cost. When we calculate the cost, then we can talk about how we can fund this implementation for these solutions. So we can talk about a box or
a fund.
Fund,
yes.
And we put the money from
each
country or from the funding people, even as a loan or grant. So what? Then we talk about or talk with us, with each other, about how we can deal with the cost of this. Projects, we can talk about that any country have to pay, they have to benefits similar to what it pay. Maybe, maybe we can make the cost for each country due to the work in its place or its border. Many idea we can we didn't talk about it yet because we talk about $10 billion for implementation. And we have to maybe more, maybe 5 years, 6 years, 7 years.
10 billions we're talking about?
Billion, yes.
Millions or billion?
Billions,
right? So where are we so far in this project? I mean, still we are completely on the paper, still we are talking with each other, I mean, to reach an agreement, or we finalized things, or where are we exactly?
Already we talk about we talk with
but
each
you mentioned
other.
Sir right now that still we cannot bring it the final because we have challenges or we have obstacles
yes.
and when we provide the solution we can find the final estimated budget.
Yeah, I talk that because any obstacles have many solutions mm-hmm. due to the
so we did not select yet.
Yes, no, who so selects these solutions is the consultant. Mm-hmm. We already prepared the terms of reference, which we will call, make a call for the consultants to introduce themselves, to have the ability to study this project and these obstacles, and then tell us how we can overcome these obstacles. Idea one, idea two, and
so
idea three.
So right now we're in the part of the visibility study itself
yes.
and the studies of the project itself and still continuing to study it. And then the next step, once that's done, the feasibility study, then we'll continue
yes, that's true.
The next step.
That's true. That's true.
Well, we'd like to
and
thank you.
And this is the steps yeah. for any project.
Yes,
we talk
of
about the visibility, the pre-visibility study. It is so good. We now talking about the visibility study, which will come soon. Mm-hmm. When we finalize and look everything and find in this project is visible with feasible solutions, mm-hmm. so we can take the next step for implementation.
Well, we hope that we manage to start that project soon. That's an important and mega project. I'd like to thank you very much. Thank you very much, Engineer Mr. Samir Salama Amara. Thank you very much for this interview. And that brings us to the end of this episode of Breakfast Show. But first of all, I have to thank my colleague, Nashwa Rosh.
Thank you, Rosha, very much. Thank you all for joining us in this episode of our Breakfast Show. And actually, remember to join us again tomorrow, same time on the Breakfast Show. Till then, thank you for joining us. I'll stay tuned for more coming up on Now TV International.